Okay students, next we're going to look at example 17. Solve the following equations for angles in the range 0 degree until 360 degree. So this is a very important information. So this is our range and it is in degree. So we're going to do all our calculation in degree. Okay, so we have 4 questions here. So this question is slightly different than what we have done before. So in our previous slide, we only tried the questions that is involved with theta. Now if you look at the example 17, we have angles such as 2 theta, 3x minus 75, 1 over 3x. So we're going to see how to answer this type of questions. Okay. For example 17a, tangent 2 theta equals to square root of 3. Okay, the main difference is now this is not theta, this is 2 theta. So remember, we were given range 0 until 360. Now this is very important. Since the range is theta, we have to change the range to 2 theta. So how does theta become 2 theta? So we multiply by 2. So we're going to do the same with the range. We're going to multiply all by 2. So your new range will be 0 until 720. So remember student, when the given range is not the same as the angle in the question, we have to find the new range. Now the range for this question is 0 until 720. Because the range given in the question is theta, main question. But for example A, is not theta, it's 2 theta. So it's very important that you modify your range before you start your question. Okay, else than that, the steps are almost similar. We're gonna start with deciding which quadrant. Okay, so since given question tangent is positive, there will be angle in your first quadrant and your third quadrant. Okay, that's the first thing we're gonna do. Second thing, we're going to find the reference angle alpha. Okay, so tangent alpha equals to square root of 3. Alpha equals to 60 degree. Arc tangent of square root of 3 is 60 degree. Now, remember, this is alpha, not theta. Now, 2 theta equals to, okay, so since we are given tangent 2 theta equals to square root of 3, and we know square root of 3 is 60 degree, so 2 theta equals to, we're gonna start with the first quadrant. We know we have angle in the first quadrant, so that's going to be 60 degree, followed by the third quadrant. Okay, third quadrant would be 180 plus 60. Okay students, now remember, this is not the only answer. Okay, we will have more answers because our range is now up to 720, which means you can go one whole circle. Okay, and you can repeat, and remember we have an angle in the first quadrant, so that's going to be the whole angle here, one whole turn here is going to be 360 plus with the angle on the first quadrant, our reference angle is 60 degree. 360 plus 60 degree. So this is still in the new range 720. And we're gonna continue this because we also have angle in the third quadrant. So we have done one whole turn. Okay, now we're going to continue until the third quadrant. Remember, this is still in our range 720. So how to find this answer? That's going to be 360 plus, okay, 180 on top here, 180, okay, plus another 60, which is the reference angle. This part here is equivalent to the reference angle, which is 60 degree. Okay, so this is our fourth angle. And we will not continue because the next, let's say we think that there's another angle. We have done one whole turn and we have found until the third quadrant. Now let's say we wish to continue. The next angle will be on the first quadrant because our angle is only on first and third quadrant. And now this angle has exceeded 720. Okay, one two whole turn will give us 720. So that's why we're gonna stop with the fourth answer. Okay, we only have four answers. Okay, let's simplify the answer. So this is going to be 60 degree followed by 240 followed by 420 and 600. Remember, this is the answer for 2 theta. We are trying to find the solution for theta. So we're going to divide each of this angle with 2. So the final answer is going to be 30, 120, 210 and 300 degree. So there's a slight difference from all the questions that we have done before. The difference is we are no more talking about theta. We are talking about 2 theta. So it's very important when there's a changes in the angle here, we have to change the range. Okay, we have to find the new range and we have to answer the question according to the new range. Okay, students. So I hope you can understand example A. Okay, we will do more example on this type of questions so that you can have a better understanding.